International School, Session 2020-21, Science, Class 4, Lesson 1, The Food We Eat. Children, today we are going to study the lesson number 1, that is, The Food We Eat. We all need food to live and grow. What happens when you don't have breakfast? Your mind does not work properly. You feel lazy. And the moment you eat something, you start feeling energetic. So that means the food gives us energy to live and grow. Now, what are the things that are present in our food which gives us this energy? That are the nutrients in food. In our food, we have some nutrients. The different types of nutrients present in food are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Our body needs all these nutrients in a fixed amount to remain healthy. Now let us start with the first nutrient, that is carbohydrates. Carbohydrates give us energy to work. So foods rich in carbohydrates are called energy giving foods. Again, foods rich in carbohydrates are called energy giving foods. Let me show you some foods that are rich in carbohydrates. Here we have milk, potato, bread. All these things are rich in carbohydrates. Now let us see the book. Is ghee, oil, nuts. All these food items are rich in fats. Now let us see the book again. But all these foods act as energy bank of the body. All these foods we eat in very less quantity, because if we eat more of fatty food, we will become obese. Obese means extremely overweight. So becoming extremely overweight is not at all good. So we should eat less of fatty foods. Now let us come to the next nutrient, that is proteins. Proteins help us to grow. So foods rich in proteins are called bodybuilding foods. Again, foods rich in protein are called bodybuilding food. Growing children need more proteins than adults. Why? Because the body of the children grows very fast. That is why they need more of proteins. That is why your mother asks you to drink milk every day, because milk is rich in protein. All milk and milk products, egg, fish, meat, pulses are all rich sources of proteins. So you should eat all these products and you should drink milk compulsorily. Let me show you some protein rich foods that I have. This is dal, you can say pulses, this is rice, and one more thing, that is milk. Now milk we have seen in carbohydrates also. So milk has carbohydrates as well as proteins. So milk is called the wholesome food because it has many nutrients in it. Now let us turn the page. Let us see the picture of foods that are rich in proteins. Fish, chicken, milk, pulses, eggs. All these things are rich in proteins. And you being children, you should eat all these things in a proper manner. Now let us start with the next nutrient, that is vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals are very essential nutrients of our body because they protect our body from diseases and keep us healthy. And that is why they are called protective foods. Again, foods rich in vitamins and minerals are called protective foods. Why? Because they protect our body from diseases. Vitamins and minerals are of various types. In our body, we need small amounts of vitamins and minerals. Some of the important minerals that are needed in the body are calcium, iron, sodium, potassium, and iodine. For example, calcium helps the body to build healthy teeth and bones, and iron helps to form blood. Now, from where do we get these minerals? We get these minerals from fruits, green leafy vegetables, sprouted beans, milk, and various other things. Let us see in the book, oranges, apples, cabbages, spinach, carrots, cauliflower. That means all types of fruits and vegetables, we get vitamins and minerals. Like I'll show you, I have orange, grapes, green vegetables, ladyfinger, and the tomatoes. All these things are rich in vitamins and minerals. So, milk is a very important part of our daily diet. Now, we come to the next part of the chapter, that is water and roughage. Now, water. Water has no nutrients, but water is very essential part of our diet. Why? Because water helps the body to digest food properly, to remove waste from the body, and to maintain the temperature of the body. These are the three important functions of water in our body. Again, functions of water are to digest food properly, to remove waste from the body, and to maintain the temperature of the body. Most food items contain some amount of water. Like if we eat fruits also, they are juicy in nature. If we eat salads also, they are also juicy in nature. So all these things contains some part of water. But apart from that, we need to drink at least 8 to 10 glasses of water every day to stay healthy. Now we come to the next part, that is roughage. Roughage is the rough fiber part of the food. Means roughage is the rough part. It cannot be digestive by our digestive system, and it does not contain nutrients also. Then why is it required in our diet? Because it gives bulk to the food and helps the body to get rid of waste easily. Means if we don't have roughage in our diet, our food will not be digested properly and we will not get rid of waste easily. Now, from where do we get roughage? Lot of roughage is found in the skin of fruits and vegetables and also in the bran of whole grains. Means if you eat a lot of fruits, vegetables, salads, you will get a lot of roughage. Now let us come to the balanced diet. As we have seen, all five types of nutrients, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, water, roughage. So the diet which contains all these things in a fixed amount, in a balanced amount, is called a balanced diet. A diet that gives the body all the nutrients in right amount is called a balanced diet. Now let us come to the next topic, cooking food. Some fruits and nuts we eat raw, but many of the food items are cooked before eating. Why cooking is necessary? Cooking is necessary because cooking kills germs, makes food soft, tasty, and easy to digest. But we should not overcook food. Why? Because overcooking will kill the nutrients also. And whatever we are eating raw, we must wash them properly before eating or cooking. Now let us come to the next topic, that is preserving food. When we leave the food in open, the germs attack it and make it unfit for eating, means the food gets spoiled. So how do we preserve, how do we protect our food from spoiling? That is called the preserving. So preserve means to treat food to prevent it from getting spoiled. Now there are many ways of preserving. Let us discuss a few. First is refrigeration. This we do at our homes also. When we keep our fruits, vegetables, cooked food in the refrigerator, it does not get spoiled easily. Why? Because the temperature inside the fridge is very low and germs cannot grow in that temperature. Now let us come to the next, that is deep freezing. Deep freezer is again a very cold place and it is used specially to keep meat, fish, vegetables like peas, carrots, etc., they are kept in the freezer to protect them from germs. Again, in the freezer, temperature is very low and germs cannot grow over there. Next is by drying. Many things like chilies are dried before keeping. Why? Because drying removes the moisture and makes the product free from germs, because germs can develop in the moisture. So when we dry these chilies, they are free from moisture and germs do not develop in it. So they are preserved. Now, next is by using preservatives. So what are the preservatives? Sugar, salt and oil are the main preservatives that we use to prevent the growth of germs. Now, what kind of food products are preserved by sugar, salt, oil, etc.? Yeah, pickles. Pickles, in pickles we put oil and salt to preserve it for many years. And jam and all are preserved by putting sugar. Pickles, vegetables such as pickles, by keeping them in oil or vinegar. We can preserve fruits such as apples or strawberries as jams by boiling them with sugar. We use salt to preserve fish. So all these are the methods to preserve the foods by salt, sugar and oil. Next is canning and bottling. Canning is a process in which food is heated in a can to kill the germs. Means food is packed in the can, then it is heated. Heat kills the germs. And when a bottle is used to heat food, it is called bottling. If it is done in can, then it is called canning. And if the process is done in a bottle, it is called bottling. As you can see in the picture, canning and bottling. We all have seen these kind of packings of rasgullas, okay, and gulab jamun. So they are preserved by canning. And this sauce is preserved by bottling. So when the food is preserved in can, it is called canning. When the food is preserved in bottle, it is called bottling. And we can keep these things for many months. With this, I conclude this chapter and I hope you enjoyed studying. Thank you.